name is Mark Hollis. I'm the coach of Full Vertical Vault Club here in Knoxville, Tennessee. So I started coaching back in about 2016. And really it all started with a little girl who just got cut from the basketball team. And her dad saw that she'd lost a lot of self-confidence and self-esteem and wondered if pole vaulting was something she could try. So that's how it started, and really that's where the passion for coaching came, because I saw in this girl that as the love and passion of pole vaulting came through, also the belief in herself and self-worth really shone through. And through my career, I had ups and downs, I had good performances and bad, and I just saw, I knew the way that it can really affect athletes. And so I wanted to be able to encourage, to teach more than just technique. I wanted to help with self-confidence and motivation and being really, just being able to speak into their lives in more ways than a regular coach a lot of times does. So that's why I love coaching, and that's why I do it every day. I vaulted professionally for 11 years, three-time national champion, two-time Olympic alternate, and decided to switch gears in 2017 and started coaching a little bit, and then also started a family and a woodworking business. So I've been coaching for about 3 years now, and we've put together a great crew of athletes.
So we start our workout with a easy warm-up, just jog around, foam rolling, stretching to get the body nice and loose. Then we start our workout with accelerations that are kind of mimicking what we do when we run with a pole. The next thing after that, we do 60-meter full-out sprints. These are very technically focused runs. While we're doing that, we'll throw in some 30-meter sled pulls, and those will have just a little bit of weight on them to get some resistance. Followed by that, we'll do quick 40-meter sprints again, just to feel what it feels like without the weight and a shorter distance. After that, we do just a quick cool down with some mobility, ease the body out of the workout to get that lactate nice and low. And that will take us all about an hour to an hour and a half usually. And that's gonna be just a sprint day for us, not a jump day or lifting or anything. So that's a pretty short day for us. Middle of the week, beginning of the week, body's feeling a little bit rough, but hopefully that will change. Middle of the cycle, so that's normal. We just gotta roll it through.
Moving to Knoxville about 3 years ago has been one of the best decisions I could have made for my training. I currently train under my coach, Mark Hollis, with the Full Vertical Elite Pole Vault Group. it has been so valuable to have a group of people to support each other, cheer each other on, and push each other towards our goals. And that's so important in the pole vault. It's such a complex event. And now that we have a facility where we can do everything we need to train, we can run, we can lift, we can pole vault, and that has given us an opportunity to be able to do that this winter and work towards our goals this year. This year, some of our goals are going to be indoor USAs, qualifying for indoor USAs, and qualifying for outdoor USAs, which is Olympic trials this year. And that will lead us to qualifying for the Olympics in 2021. So we are so excited to do that here in Knoxville and push each other along to reach these goals.
What are you eating between practices today?
Blueberries and strawberries and a sandwich.
Miss?
Got Yoplait yogurt with granola and chocolate chips.
Nice. Lunch between lifting and vaulting.
We had gymnastics practice, and at gymnastics we like to do basically a full routine throughout the whole facility if we can. So we start usually on the ground. We'll do some jogging and some general stretches mixed in with some different floor routines, whether it be rolling or cartwheels or backflips or front flips. Then we head over to the rings, warm the shoulders up a little bit, straight over to the parallel bars, and we do a bunch of different walks and swings on those, just getting some mobility movements and some strength movements and just body awareness. Then we went back to rings to do our rings workout, which is just a lot of different swings and things that directly correlate to our pole vault training. Then from there, we move on to the parallel bars where we do some kips and some different gymnastics moves, as well as some more swings specific to the pole vault with a different style. Then we finish it all off with some core on the stall bars. And now we're just rolling out, cooling down, and headed home to eat.
The reason why I pole vault is for one of two reasons. For one, it makes me a better athlete, and also makes me a better person. So with pole vault, you always end in a failure, so the bar always falls down at the end of the day. However, it's up to me to understand what that failure truly means. I can sit there and take that failure, and I can think about it as a negative thing, or really, I could just use it and just use it as a point to just get better and how to improve and not even associate any negative feelings towards it. It's like, yes, look at all the positive that I've done to even get to the point that I could potentially fail at that bar and jump at a height that I've never jumped at. So every day, my reason to pole vault is because I just, for one, I love it, and two, I just become a better athlete because there's so many like ways to improve, from your physical to your mental, and all the way down on how you think about certain situations, as in, you know, failure, positivity, success, and just all of it. It's something that really has truly has pushed me.
Let's go!